Welcome everyone. Thanks a lot for staying with us. You're watching Plain Speak with me, Shivani Gupta, and we're joining you live from the CNN News 18 Federal Bank Primetime Studio. Ahead of the swearing-in on Sunday evening, NDA leaders endorsed Narendra Modi as the parliamentary party leader today, paving the way for him to be the Prime Minister of India for the third consecutive time. Senior BJP leader Rajnath Singh proposed Modi's name as NDA parliamentary party's leader, a motion supported by Amit Shah, Nitin Gadkari and top NDA leaders. Rajnath Singh emphasized the alliance reflects BJP's commitment, not just a necessity. All eyes were on the top two allies, TDP chief Chandrababu Naidu and JDU chief Nitish Kumar. They were wholesome in their praise and in their statement of support for the Modi-led NDA government. In fact, some would say Nitish Kumar stole the show, especially when he said, "Agli baar jab aap aayenge, to kuch log jo idhar udhar jeet gaye hain, agli baar sab haarenge, humko pura bharosa hai." He reiterated that JDU will stand with PM Modi in all his decisions. And the Prime Minister's messaging was also very clear. 2024 is a grand victory for NDA, even if the opposition tries to reject it. He also said that he hoped opposition MPs will contribute to nation building when they come to Parliament. Even as this is playing out, there is some unease coming out in the opposition ranks. TMC General Secretary Abhishek Banerjee is holding separate meetings with some members of the India bloc, minus the Congress. So the NDA presents this mazboot message, while fissures, some would say, emerge in the India bloc. Who will emerge stronger in the longer run is the question we take to our guests in just a bit. First up, some scenes from the NDA meeting earlier today. The Prime Minister bowing to the Samvidhan. Prime Minister held up the Constitution in his hands and bowed before it. Remember, the charge of changing the Constitution, if they were to get a big mandate, certainly a 400-page kind of mandate, was the big attack by the opposition in this election. And some would say that eroded the BJP at the ground level. Another symbolic moment today was JDU President and Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar bowing to touch the Prime Minister's feet, or at least attempting to do so. The Prime Minister stopped him in between, but a moment that will have much symbolism nonetheless. And this is how another NDA ally endorsed the Prime Minister at the parliamentary party meet. LJP Chief Chirag Paswan, who has previously described himself as the Hanuman of the NDA or of Prime Minister Modi, hugging the Prime Minister today with respect after declaring his support, of course, to Prime Minister at the meeting. He walked up to him, shook his hand and started hugging him. Let's also get you the big messaging from the NDA meeting today. While addressing the NDA parliamentary meeting, Prime Minister-elect Narendra Modi sent this message to the naysayers. In a message to them, he said that we did not lose, we have not lost, because a lot is being said as far as the verdict is concerned. He also mentioned how Congress seats in last three elections is less than ours in 2024. So if you combine the total seats that Congress has won in the last three elections, they're still less than 240 that BJP has earned alone this time around. EVM made them silent. That is the power of democracy. The Prime Minister not missing this chance to take a dig at those who were questioning whether the verdict is going to be reliable, whether the system is reliable, electoral politics in India is reliable, because all of them have now accepted it, rejoiced over it, clearly showing democracy is well and truly alive in India. The opposition will disintegrate. Leaders are already saying that the alliance was not for state polls. He also reminded that while all of us are together as the NDA, look what is happening to the opposition India bloc. And he said that I had said this, that post June 4, there will be problems as far as the India bloc is concerned. Now, while endorsing Narendra Modi as the leader, the NDA allies also firmly showed their support. And these are the big statements that they made. So taking a dig at the opposition, Bihar Chief Minister and JDU Chief Nitish Kumar said, opposition has never served the nation and will lose all seats next time. Hailing leadership of Prime Minister Modi in the past two terms, TDP Chief Naidu said he's the right leader at the right time for India and that India has become global powerhouse under his leadership. NDA's key alliance partner in Maharashtra, Ekanath Shinde, said the pact between Shiv Sena and BJP is strong in Maharashtra. A lot of activity is going on in Maharashtra, frankly. Both Ajit Pawar and Ekanath Shinde camps are facing some trouble, we are being told. But he was there. He supported the NDA wholeheartedly. LJP chief Chirag Paswan hailed Prime Minister-elect and said India believes in PM Modi as its leader. BJP's key UP partner Anupriya Patel, Apna Dal chief, said that they will work together for India's development. This is Jitin Ram Manji of the HAM also saying that with Modi under all circumstances, that they continue to stand with Narendra Modi. There's also, of course, Janasena chief Pawan Kalyan, who endorsed the Prime Minister while he was speaking today. He said that Narendra Modi has truly inspired the nation. Just to contrast this, while the NDA is, of course, presenting this picture that all is well, that anybody from the outside who's thinking that there are some troubles that are going to happen or some alliance partners are either going to bargain too hard or going to ditch the BJP, which is short of a 272 mark, what is happening on the other side? So there are two developments which are of note. One, of course, is that the TMC, the AAP and the Shiv Sena UBT faction are actually all meeting each other. They want to, we are being told, shore up numbers, maybe to stake claim. I don't know how that's going to happen. But the Congress, of course, wants to take its own appropriate time at decision at an appropriate time. And largely the message from the India Alliance has been that this is not the time for us to stake claim. We don't have the numbers. We're not going to attempt it. But TMC General Secretary Abhishek Banerjee did hold separate meetings with Uddhav Thackeray and Akhilesh Yadav and Aam Aadmi Party leaders. What does that mean? Is the Congress again being sidelined, or are there some problems as far as the alliance is concerned? On the other hand, while this is not too much of a surprise, maybe some expected that there would be some rethink, because AAP had always said, we are coming together as far as the national picture is concerned. They have reiterated that the Congress and the AAP will not have an alliance as far as the assembly elections in Delhi coming up very soon is concerned, and they're going to go solo. Could that also create some consternation as far as the opposition camp is concerned is another big question. With that, we lead to our big question today. Exactly which of these alliances will emerge stronger and will continue to stay strong as far as the next term is concerned between the NDA and the INDIA? Exactly which is going to be stronger as we go along?
Vijay ki god mein उन्माद पैदा नहीं होता है और न ही पराजित लोगों के प्रति उपहास करने के हमारे संस्कार है। सीट नहीं जीत पाए, लेकिन जिस तेजी से एनडीए का वोट शेयर बढ़ा है वो साफ साफ संदेश दे रहा है कल में क्या लिखा हुआ है। सरकार चलाने के लिए बहुमत आवश्यक है, लोकतंत्र का वही एक सिद्धांत है, लेकिन देश चलाने के लिए सर्वमत बहुत जरूरी होता है।
Country has witnessed remarkable progress and transformation. Narendra Modi's focused and dedicated approach has transformed the nation into a global powerhouse.
उन लोगों ने आज तक कोई काम नहीं किया, देश की कोई सेवा नहीं की, आगे अब उन लोगों के लिए कोई गुंजाइश नहीं रहेगा, वो सब खत्म हो गया।
अरे जो यहाँ दिखता है ना पवन, ये पवन नहीं आंधी है।
Just a quick update. These are visuals coming in of the Prime Minister's carcade reaching the Rashtrapati Bhavan. This is, of course, the appointment that they have sought after the NDA parliamentary party meeting, where they're going to stake claim or at least ask for time for the swearing in. The swearing in, of course, is slated for Sunday this weekend at 6 p.m. Let me also introduce the guests who are joining us on the show. Syed Zafar Islam, national spokesperson of the BJP with us. Pooja Tripathi of the Congress Party. Suman Sriraman, political analyst, joining us. R. Rajagopalan, senior journalist. And also Vivek Sila, spokesperson of Samajwadi Party. Let me go across to Pooja Tripathi first. Pooja Tripathi, the Prime Minister's, you know, making it very clear that the Congress and the India bloc has less to rejoice than they are doing or indulging in right now. After all, the Congress's combined result from the last three elections is less than what the BJP has managed alone. This is a reminder that this is not exactly Congress or India bloc's victory.
Shivani, Prime Minister should stop comparing Congress total tally last three elections, and he should compare what he gave the number to the country, that is 370 and 400 par. The biggest takeaway of this election is Prime Minister bowing down before Constitution, that this country would be run by Constitution. Constitution is sacrosanct, not some Avinashi, non-biological somebody who claims to have divine powers, and that's the biggest. The biggest takeaway of this election is now Prime Minister Modi, the government will not run away from with the whims and fancies and megalomania of one person. It would be consensus, it would be deliberation, it would be discussion, it would be debate, it would be coordination, and that is how.
But that's also the responsibility of the opposition, right, Pooja?
Opposition, Shivani, opposition has been, when 150 MPs are thrown out of the parliament, when the main opposition party's accounts are freezed, when there's a high-headed misuse of central agencies, opposition, and this is the result of opposition. If he doesn't say that, his take that it's not to rejoice, but the country has given a mandate. Country gave you a brutal mandate in 2019. To work for unemployment, to work for inflation, to work for the people of India. Now they have given you a fractured mandate so that you get down from your high horses and work for the people of India. And I think that's a big thing to rejoice. The people of India have spoken up that alone Bharatiya Janata Party does not have the numbers to cross the majority.
Yeah, but that's not quite something to rejoice for you, or is it?
Of course it is. We talked about issues. While Prime Minister talked about Mujra, Mutton, Machli, Mangal Sutra, Mullah, Madarsa and things like that, all we talked about was people's issue, and this is the mandate for people's issue.
But you didn't get the mandate.
But we got the numbers.
No, you didn't get the numbers. Which numbers are you talking about?
Shivani, what is the Bharatiya Janata Party's number?
They will defend their numbers, but what are your numbers? Your numbers are not a mandate.
They could not reach up to 370.
Yeah, I got that. They couldn't reach 370. I got that. But you're not someone who has the mandate with you either. Let's have the humility to accept that too.
We are having a humility, and that's why we want Prime Minister to get down from his arrogance.
Okay, fine. He's down from his high horse. My question is to you. You don't have the mandate either. So you will also have to show the humility to work together with the government that will be in power.
Together, the duty of opposition is to ask questions, and we have started that.
Yeah.
We have asked the opposed government first.
No, I'm wondering exactly that. If those questions that have been posed on the stock market alleged scam are to disrupt the first parliamentary session that is coming in, because we've seen that pattern, right? Before every parliamentary session, there is one JPC demand, there is one scam alleged. Nothing really happens of any of those scam allegations. Some of them have been rejected by the Supreme Court. So maybe the public also wants, to move on from that kind of politics. You've given your message and then get on with the work that Parliament needs to do. We've all seen how Rahul Gandhi responded when he was asked a question about Parliament functioning. If that is what the attitude is, then one can also allege that there is no humility on the opposition side either.
No, tell me one thing. What is the duty of opposition? Opposition's duty is to raise questions, and it's not the government's duty.
It's not to rip out mics. I've seen that also happening. It's not to rip out mics. It's not to throw papers. It's not to bring placards into the parliament, etc. Let's not go down that road, because it will become like, what one side did, what another side did. My point is very clear. Who is this mandate for? I'll give Syed Zafar Islam an opportunity to respond to the Congress, and then we'll of course talk about exactly which alliance has more in its favor to survive, if it was to survive for the next 5 years. Yes, Syed Zafar Islam, off your high horse and humility, and you will have to bow down to the verdict too, not just to the constitution book in parliament. You will have to make sure you have consensus, not just within the NDA, but also across the aisle.
Well, let me respond to what you asked and what the Congress spokesperson was speaking just now. First of all, we are not answerable to Congress party. We are answerable to the people of this great country. We as a responsible party, we know the responsible citizens have voted for us, and it's a historic mandate for the Honorable Prime Minister, third time in a row. He will be taking oath as the Prime Minister. And he understands his responsibility well. For last 10 years, he's discharging his responsibility, where he has taken everyone along. Whether it's a consensus within the NDA setup, whether outside, I'm sure that within NDA, there is absolutely no problem. But yes, I do suspect that there could be some problem when we have to bring opposition parties on the same platform, purely because they have made up their mind always to disrupt the parliament. And last few sessions we have seen how disruptive they were. So they do not want the business to be transacted in the parliament. They do not want to make the parliament run. They do not want legislation to be made, purely because all the legislation are aimed to benefit the country and the people of this great country. But
some of the legislation will not be my way or the highway either, is the message that the opposition wants to give. That some of the legislations which the BJP may feel are the right legislations for the country, you will have to get your allies on board also, first step, and you will also have to contend with a much stronger, more vociferous opposition.
Shivani, we are not overly concerned at all. We are not concerned at all as far as the NDA. A team is concerned. NDA block is always behind the Honorable Prime Minister, because everyone has expressed that their policy is nation first, and the people of this great country is the priority of every political party, and this is what we have to deliver. This is what we this is what we have
Syed Zafar Islam, do you not feel that there is a certain message for you too, that there, if there are contentious issues, you need to kind of let it run its course and figure out all the concerns that are coming either via parliament or outside parliament, and then decide to go ahead. That is the message for you too.
Shivani, I have been a member of parliament, so I understand the dynamics there within outside and within the parliament. But this is very important to understand that when the business advisory committee meets, where the committee is represented by many political parties, and the discussion takes place where the agenda is decided. Once the agenda for the discussion is decided, that should be discussed on the floor of the parliament. What was happening in the past, last few sessions, that business advisory committee agreed for certain agenda to be discussed on the floor of the parliament, but they started disrupting it, because most of the political parties having agreed in the BSC, but they retracted when on the parliament.
Okay.
On the
floor, so let's just hope that parliament. The floor of the parliament.
This is something where we expect them to be responsible.
No, fair enough. We hope that the floor of the parliament does not become a political battlefield. Just a second.
So we expect them to be more responsible. We expect them that they also understand the responsibility they carry on their shoulder as a member of parliament, and each party has the responsibility to help the government to pass legislation, because it is for everyone's benefit. It is for the country. It is for the people of this country. So if somebody creates the issue, I'm sure that the opposition bench, within the opposition bench, some people will definitely, we will pursue with them, make them understand, and will give them sense what is important for the nation and not for your
fair enough. I want to go across to Suman C. Raman also. Suman C. Raman, how do you read the optics of the NDA parliamentary party meeting today? Would you say that some people were maybe salivating a little bit too much at the prospect that BJP is going to be dependent on the allies, at least their top two allies? they seem to have wholeheartedly supported not just Narendra Modi's leadership, but also the NDA government. So do you expect this government to be rocked at all, or do you expect it could be smooth sailing for them actually?
Look, I think it's way too early, Shivani, to actually talk about whether it's going to be rough weather or smooth sailing. For starters, we do not know the composition of the cabinet. We do not know the demands that have been made on the BJP by the allies. We do not know who is the speaker or which party the speaker is going to belong to. Hmm. All of these will give you a clue as to which way things could go. Also, there are certain contentious issues on which some of the allies don't agree. Caste census, for instance, which is a demand of Nitish Kumar. Also, the scrapping of the Agniveer scheme, which is again one of the demands that the JDU has been very vocal about. Now, if special status is given to Bihar and Andhra Pradesh, what happens when similar demands come from other states? So there are a lot of issues which need to be looked at and to see which way the government's policy making is going to go. And it's way too early for that.
Okay, see, one second. Can I just interrupt you for a brief 30 seconds? Because the visuals on our screen are the present visuals that are coming in of the Prime Minister-elect Narendra Modi meeting President of the country, Draupadi Murmu, and they're going to seek the appointment to... They're staking claim for the next government. They're going to, of course, seek the appointment for the swearing-in as well. That swearing-in is all slated for Sunday evening. Yes, Sumansi Raman, please continue.
Yeah. So, I think today's meeting was more a procedural one. So, where the NDA leaders are expected to say good things. You don't expect them to say, okay, we are putting the government on notice. We don't know how long it will last. No, that will not come. I mean, look, Mr. Nitish Kumar and Mr. Chandrababu Naidu are probably the two most seasoned politicians in India today. Hmm. In fact, the experience of Mr. Naidu is more than the experience of Mr. Modi, because he has been a chief minister even earlier. Hmm. So I think that you have to understand that they are not going to be prone to impulsive decisions, but they will extract their pound of flesh. They are too canny, and they know how dependent this government is completely going to be on them.
Okay.
And also the smaller allies like Chirag Paswan or Eknath Shinde and so on. Mr. Shinde is going to have a hard time continuing, as Maharashtra chief minister.
His flock together, as some of the suspicions
are. Yeah, he's keeping his flock together. Ajit Pawar has got a huge challenge. In fact, the rumors are in the next few days itself, there will be some kind of homecoming for his MPs. So there are, for his party men, he doesn't have too many MPs in any case. But the point really is that we will know over the next few weeks. And the first sign will be the composition of the cabinet.
Okay, but what about the other side? Suman, what about the other side? Is the other side somehow this homogeneous bloc you think is not going to face any issues? Even when it comes to presenting a united face on issues against the NDA, next NDA government?
Shivani, first of all, I want to make a correction. The Aam Aadmi Party and the Congress made it very clear that they were not tying up for the state election.
Yeah, I said that. They reiterated it only.
Yeah, so it is something which is already known that none of the India Alliance partners have said that they are going to forever continue in an alliance. Hmm. They have come together for a very specific purpose, and that purpose was to remove the BJP from power. That has not happened. They have succeeded partially in ensuring that the BJP does not get a majority on its own, and that the party is going to be dependent on a number of allies, some of whom are not known for being very reliable allies. So to that extent, they have succeeded. But the India Alliance is not in a position to form any government, which is why they have...
No, but what about even staying together as the united opposition? Do you see them on every issue, at every turn, really presenting a united face? We've seen during the campaign itself... We've seen during the campaign itself, they were failing at so many points to present a united face.
No. See, Shivani, in Parliament, I am very confident that the India Alliance will present a united face, because quite honestly, on several of these issues, these parties are sharing a common plank. So, for instance, on the Agniveer scheme, most of the parties of the India Alliance are on the same page. On a caste census, that was part of the Congress manifesto, but many of the other parties have also spoken in terms of a caste census.
What about when DMK makes Sanatan Dharma is a pest kind of comments, then what happens?
There is no policy decision to be made on Sanatan Dharma. There is a policy decision to be taken.
Well, the opposition is not in the business of policy decision in any case. They will have to present their
government
view
is,
and a united
so
view on the issues that confront the country.
Shivani, they can get together and oppose it. And in parliament, it's not going to be the my way or the highway kind of things where 20 bills are passed in five minutes discussion and so on. That's
all
not
right.
going to happen.
Are Rajagopalan tough road ahead for NDA or for the INDIA?
For INDIA. The reason being, Shivani, today's Prime Minister's speech was a statesman-like speech. Prime Minister gave certain important, you know, revelations that it's a good governance that matters. Apart from that, Sabka Vishwas. And second thing, he said it's an organic alliance. Apart from that, Shivani, Prime Minister also had a jibe at EVM. What Congress Kapil Sibal was telling 2 days before, India will burn, India will put, even Rahul Gandhi has spoken in Parliament before the no confidence motion. Aag lag jayega. Kahan aag jaga? And second thing, Shivani, you remember, Mr. Rahul Gandhi quoted Muchewara's song, 295. Mm. They could not even reach 230. Mm. Why did even that did not give a fillip to the stock market? And second thing, Prime Minister's focus is on South. Today, Prime Minister has given, you know, the greetings to Pawan and also to Chirag Paswan. That itself is a matter. And second thing...
He'll have to take away a little bit of his focus on South and now divert that focus at least to Andhra Pradesh and Bihar. No, he's got both of those allies to contend with.
Yes, yes. Bihar and after Mr. Nitish Kumar's speech and Mr. Chandrababu Naidu's speech, there is no room for any suspicion. At least, you know, my understanding is, what did Nitish Kumar say? Jo bhi jeet gaya, agle baar jeetenge nahi hai. That type of message he sent. Second, India Alliance. You talked about the India Alliance. Prime Minister took heavily on India Alliance. What is the use of stock market yesterday, the press conference? It has no basis. And all the, you know, stock market experts, today's stock market is doing well. So therefore, Mr. Rahul Gandhi's enmity with Mr. Narendra Modi, and that was very well established by his speech, and this, you know, third time Agya, they were all saying, Priyanka Gandhi said Congress will touch the ruling party status and BJP will touch 120. What happened to her poll card? Did he want to?
No, so obviously both sides will project certain numbers. I don't think we should harp on that beyond a certain point. Life has moved on. But don't you think, R. Rajagopalan, that it is going to be tricky for Narendra Modi? It is going to be tricky for the BJP. Do you think they'll have a policy that, okay, we'll adjust only so far and no more because they also have a core ideology and a core constituency that cannot digest certain, compromises that will be possibly expected?
Prime Minister clarified it very well. Without any common minimum program, it is also Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas. Majority is a must for running this, you know, system. But consensus is sarvamat chahiye. What does it mean? Consensus. So therefore, whatever my previous speaker was mentioning about Agnipath, etc., as even caste census, this will be discussed. Prime Minister said, I am available for 24/7. He appreciated the opposition MPs also. What a statesman. Did Mr. Rahul Gandhi or Priyanka Gandhi greet Prime Minister?
Okay. I want to go across to Vivek Silas, who's been waiting very patiently. Vivek, I want to understand from you, you know, what does it mean and what message does it send when an Abhishek Banerjee is holding separate meetings with the likes of Akhilesh Yadav, with the likes of the Aam Aadmi Party and others? What is going on?
I think, first of all, good evening to all of you. I think that this is not a point of discussion at the moment, but that Mr. Abhishek Banerjee is meeting people like Samajwadi Party, Akhilesh Yadav, or Aam Aadmi Party. That doesn't make a difference whether he's meeting or he's not. What difference does it make?
No, we want to know what you're discussing. You're telling the country that, you know, you have got such a great victory, and certainly in Uttar Pradesh, the Samajwadi Party has scored a victory. That one can certainly be counted as a victory. So why are you so shy from telling us what you're discussing with your allies, partners?
There is nothing very substantial about it that we can tell it right now. But the only thing that I can say is the opposition will definitely be standing with the, if the decisions are taken in the favor of the country, you know. The special status will be given to Bihar, Andhra Pradesh. And as JDU said, that the Agni Veer system should be abolished as soon as possible. There are a lot of things that has to be taken into consideration.
You are saying issue by issue, you are open to what the government may present in parliament.
You know, you cannot come at 8 p.m. and say, ki, oh, ab note band kar do. You cannot come at 10 p.m. and say, oh, lockdown kar do. No, this is not going to happen. This was just dictatorship that was happening, what the people of India saw. That is why such a mandate was given by the people of India, because the parliamentarians who are elected by the opposition parliamentarians, they are also elected by the people of the same country, you know. They are also elected by the people of the same country, and they are also supposed to serve the country.
No, but Vivek, I have a question. You're saying that you can't decide when the lockdown will happen, etc. But that's what the government is chosen for, right? The opposition cannot hope to partake in all governance-related issues. That's not what you've been chosen for either.
I was just trying to explain you. Anything that has to be decided will be decided by the NDA now. That is the problem.
The NDA, okay. No, I want to understand the opposition's position. NDA, I'll understand, but I want to understand the opposition's position. How long do you think all of you can come and keep together? For example, fine, the Aam Aadmi Party and Congress will not want to fight the Delhi Assembly elections together. That was what the Aam Aadmi Party's position in any case was. And Aam Aadmi Party is so far ahead of others in Delhi that they wouldn't see any possible reason for that alliance in Delhi. What about the Samajwadi Party and Congress in UP?
As far as the Samajwadi Party and Congress is concerned in Uttar Pradesh, definitely you've seen the chemistry of Rahul Gandhiji and Akhilesh Yadav. You have seen it, how people greeted them, how people were, just behind, standing behind them.
And no, that is why I'm asking you this, because once when you combined for state polls, it was not that great a result for you.
You know, it was always said that Honorable Prime Minister said Uttar Pradesh ke shahzade hain, UP ke ladke na. Eventually, what happened? You know, we got 44 seats in Uttar Pradesh, and there were many seats that we lost by a margin of five seats by a margin of just 5,000 votes. And if you see, if you compare the Varanasi victory of Shri Narendra Modi, he just could manage to win by 1,52,000 votes. That is all.
So you are saying for the next state assembly elections, you are very much together. There's not going to be any rethink on that.
No. Once we join hands, we'll be together, and in the parliament also, you will see that the chemistry of Samajwadi Party and the entire opposition will be there to question. If at all, the farm laws, like the three black laws that came and no discussion was made and it was just passed. So now such things cannot happen, ma'am. That is the thing I was trying to say. And even the viewers should know, the dictatorship will not be allowed in the parliament now. You have to work according to the Constitution of India. That is our motive. And we will support the government if the government is doing well for the welfare of the country. But if the government is taking the side of the industrialist or something like that, and some things which we feel are not good for the country, definitely we have to oppose it. The opposition has to ask questions, and the government has to.
Asking questions is fine, but disrupting governance to a point that either parliament doesn't function or you oppose each and every decision a government makes purely because it's somebody else's government in power, I don't think it goes down. No, you may not say that, but we've witnessed signs of that where everything was opposed. Even the vaccine made in India was opposed. And I dare remind you,
what happened
your leader Akhilesh Yadav said this is BJP's vaccine.
But that quote unquote
BJP vaccine has turned out to be the safest vaccine in the market. But it was opposed at one time.
Why is AstraZeneca taking back those vaccines?
Sir, you called the other one BJP's vaccine, not AstraZeneca.
Why have they given an affidavit in England, the vaccine company?
You're confusing Covaxin and Covishield. Covaxin faced
innumerable
questions purely because it was a vaccine that was made and produced in India. and everybody from the opposition was raising questions.
And I'm scared.
No, one second. Everybody, one second. We've got to cut across. I think the Prime Minister is about to speak. Let's just listen it.
नमस्ते साथियों, चुनाव में जैसे हम लोगों को भी दौड़ धूप रहती है, मीडिया के साथियों को भी बहुत परिश्रम करना पड़ता है, रात दिन दौड़ना पड़ता है, अलग अलग लोकेशन को कवर करना पड़ता है, तो आप लोगों ने भी बहुत कष्ट उठाया है। मैं आशा करता हूं कि मीडिया जगत के सभी साथियों का स्वास्थ्य अच्छा रहा होगा और पिछले एकाध सप्ताह का जो विराम मिला है उसके कारण भी अब आप फ्रेश होकर के फिर से मैदान में आए होंगे। तो 18वीं लोकसभा, और वैसे भी हमारे यहाँ व्यक्ति के जीवन में 18वीं इसका बड़ा महत्व होता है, एक नए कालखंड में प्रवेश करता है टीन एज समाप्त करके। ये 18वीं लोकसभा एक प्रकार से नई ऊर्जा, युवा ऊर्जा और कुछ कर गुजरने के इरादे वाली ये लोकसभा है। और आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव के बाद का ये पहला चुनाव है, और एक प्रकार से ये वो 25 वर्ष हैं जो हमारे अमृतकाल के 25 वर्ष हैं, और जो 2047 देश जब आजादी की शताब्दी मनाता होगा, एक प्रकार से उन सपनों को साकार करने का एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण पड़ाव ये 18वीं लोकसभा है। साथियों, एनडीए सरकार को तीसरी बार देश की सेवा करने का देशवासियों ने आदेश दिया है, अवसर दिया है। मैं देशवासियों का फिर से एक बार ये अवसर देने के लिए हृदय से आभार व्यक्त करता हूं, और मैं देशवासियों को विश्वास देता हूं कि पिछले दो टर्म में जिस गति से देश आगे बढ़ा है, समाज के हर क्षेत्र में परिवर्तन साफ साफ नजर आ रहा है, 25 करोड़ लोगों का गरीबी से बाहर आना, ये अपने आप में हर भारतीय के लिए बड़ा गर्व का विषय है। और मैं देशवासियों को विश्वास दिलाता हूं कि 18वीं लोकसभा में भी, हमारे 5 साल के कार्यकाल में भी, हम उसी गति के साथ, उतने ही समर्पण भाव से देश की आशा आकांक्षाओं को पूर्ण करने में कोई कमी नहीं रखेंगे। आज सुबह एनडीए की मीटिंग हुई थी, एनडीए के सभी साथियों ने मुझे फिर से एक बार इस दायित्व के लिए पसंद किया है, और सभी एनडीए के साथियों ने राष्ट्रपति जी को इसकी जानकारी दी, और राष्ट्रपति जी ने मुझे अभी बुलाया था और मुझे प्रधानमंत्री डेजिग्नेटेड के रूप में काम कर रहे, एक निमंत्रण नियुक्ति दी है और मुझे शपथ समारोह के लिए और मंत्रिपरिषद के सदस्यों के सूची के लिए उन्होंने सूचित किया है। मोटे तौर पर मैंने राष्ट्रपति जी को कहा है कि हमें 9 तारीख शाम को सुविधा रहेगी, अब बाकी डिटेल तो राष्ट्रपति भवन वर्कआउट करेगा और हम तब तक मंत्रिपरिषद की सूची राष्ट्रपति जी को सुपुर्द करेंगे, उसके बाद शपथ समारोह होगा। साथियों, सरकार एनडीए की एक प्रकार से एनडीए 1, एनडीए 2 एंड एनडीए 3 ये एक निरंतरता है और हमारे संकल्पों को लेकर के, सुशासन के प्रति हमारी प्रतिबद्धता को लेकर के और देश के सामान्य जन के सपनों को पूरा करने के प्रयास के रूप में इस निरंतरता को हम और अधिक ऊर्जा के साथ और अधिक व्यापक विजन के साथ आगे बढ़ाएंगे और समय सीमा में लक्ष्यों को प्राप्त करने का हमारा प्रयास रहेगा। 2014 में मैं बहुत नया था, मुझे अब एक लंबे समय तक इस कार्य का अनुभव मिला है, हमारी टीम को अनुभव मिला है और इसलिए हमारे लिए अब तुरंत ही काम को आगे बढ़ाना बहुत ही सरल रहने वाला है और इस अनुभव का लाभ भी देश की सेवा करने में मिलने वाला है। इन 10 साल के कार्यकाल के दरमियान भारत की वैश्विक जो छवि बनी है, दुनिया के लिए एक विश्व बंधु के रूप में भारत उभरा है, इसका मैक्सिमम एडवांटेज अब शुरू हो रहा है और मुझे पक्का विश्वास है ये 5 वर्ष वैश्विक परिवेश में भी भारत के लिए बहुत उपयोगी होने वाले हैं। दुनिया अनेक संकटों से गुजर रही है, अनेक तनावों से गुजर रही है, अनेक आपदाओं से गुजर रही है। ऐसी विकट परिस्थिति दुनिया ने बहुत लंबे अरसे के बाद देखी है। हर देश इन सारी समस्याओं के बीच अपने आप को बचाए रखना, बढ़ाते रहना, चुनौतियों का डगर डगर पर सामना कर रहा है। हम भारत वाले लोग, हम भारतवासी खुद नसीब हैं कि इतने बड़े संकटों के बावजूद भी हम आज विश्व की सबसे तेज गति से बढ़ने वाली इकोनॉमी के रूप में जाने गए हैं। ग्रोथ के विषय में भी दुनिया में हमारी वाहवाही हो रही है। अब एक स्टेबल गवर्नमेंट मिलने के कारण और परिचित व्यवस्था और नेतृत्व मिलने के कारण दुनिया का भारत के प्रति रुझान, भारत के प्रति उनका आना बहुत तेज गति से होने वाला है और मुझे विश्वास है कि देश के सभी राज्यों को इसका लाभ मिलेगा, देश की युवा पीढ़ी को सबसे ज्यादा लाभ मिलेगा। विकास के नए ऊंचाइयों को छूने में एक वैश्विक भागीदारी का वातावरण आने वाले 5 साल में बनने वाला है। तो इसी संकल्पों और आदर्शों के साथ हम आगे बढ़ेंगे। मैं राष्ट्रपति जी का हृदय से आभार व्यक्त करता हूं कि एक बहुत बड़े महत्वपूर्ण दायित्व के लिए उन्होंने मुझे निमंत्रित किया है। आप सबका भी दोस्तों बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। थैंक यू।